Alrighty, so week 10 learn together. I was looking at what we finished. So at this point, you finished section 8 of the Udemy course. And it really got me thinking about that we probably in the learn together don't have time to build something, complete. That is what the goal for your learn together is. But I find also one of the best ways to know if you really understand something is to modify it. So here's what I want you to do. Take the output from either the Notes app or the To-Do app and make a major add a major feature, okay, to either one, and it should be one there. But and also sorry about that. We also each need to make different modifications, okay? And so the question would be, what's major, right? So I'm going to show you mine, and then right there's other there just off the top of my head, I was thinking about a few things, right? Implement a category for either one, to do or notes. Add animation to either one. Gamify either app. And so much more, right? So those were just the ones that kind of rolled off the top of my head. So the goal I'm going to do, or my goal, and I actually just finished it when I wrote this, it was still a goal. And here's what I want to tell you. It took me longer than I thought. And honestly, that's pretty normal, is that the thing, if like you have an idea about A, what you want to change, and then B, you have to go in and figure out based on the way the code is how to change that. So it took me longer than I expected. And the solution I ended up coming up with was simpler than my first two approaches. And this too is very common, is that your first way of thinking about this. And it's really, I wish I could tell you there's a shortcut. Part of this is just the way you look at, think about, and understand first what you want to do, and then how the code is written to allow you to do it. So this to me, this assignment really is going to help us both understand how well you understand the two apps that you wrote with Andrew, okay? All right, so I'm going to show you my output. I'm going to go over the code. It's over here. But what you need to do is write 150 first, get code working, right? That's the most important thing here, is get working code done. And then do two replies. Now, here's the other thing, is that you're welcome to reserve your modification concept before you write your code. All you'd have to do is hit reply here and give us like a brief description, and that way other people know. So if you're doing this whenever you're starting in and you've made a decision, you can modify that decision, but just come in here and reserve that idea so that everybody knows what you're working on. And again, I'm sure based on the last, well, last week there was no coding. It was more you thinking about the develop it, the dev one. But I know that there's going to be ideas I haven't even begun to think about here. All right, so here's mine. What I did is I took the to-dos and I added a name. Now, this would obviously in a next iteration, in a future iteration, would be authentication, right? Again, authentication is something we learn when you're in Node. We learn how to do authentication, and many times you're either using somebody else's authentication library. But in this case, I'm simulating the idea. So if I was to say, okay, enter a name, hit submit. Oh, helps when I start the server. I just pushed my code, no wonder. I'm going to start my server. Let me come back over here. Close that one out, right? So this is one I haven't used before. So in this case, it gives a welcome to, it is actually not a welcome, but it shows whose to-dos we're looking at. And if you do like code up, so I'm going to add that. Cool, it's there. More code based on my last 2 days. It didn't take me all of 2 days. There were just various parts of it, right? So first I have two to-dos, and then all I'm going to do here is change. Cool. Let's say Jane D. Cool. Jane has no to-dos. That's nice. Okay. So she is going to clean up. No, actually, I'm not going to give Jane a cleanup. She's a woman. That's just this. No, sorry. That's crazy. That's a joke. Take out trash. How about that? It's funny how when you have to come up with things. Okay. So now if I change and I put back my original one, then it will remember the to-dos. And if I delete, right, and change and come back. Now, by the way, there's some things I definitely would want to do here. And part of what we talked about, and let me go ahead and show you this, is at minimum, and some, I think it was Julian who asked me this, like at minimum, if I hit submit, I want to give a message. And actually, there is a message in the back there, but I'm also going to write a little more validation here as we all agreed. But for now, at bare minimum, I can't do anything because there's nothing in there. And there is a must provide in here. So how did I handle this? So what I did is I took the idea, I can show you this up in the top. So I took the idea of what we got in notes with reading by getting the hash from the, getting it, pulling it off of the URL. So in this case, when it's entered, and then I just save that and I'll show you the code here, but you can see it as well. I will provide my code, of course. But so on my index file is I just created that simple welcome, that form. I did a form, and the reason I did a form is so that at bare minimum, I could do a require. And the require is like the absolute bare minimum, and it's not enough. I'm going to write a little more, but I just wanted to get this video. So you'll see when you see it, it should have a little message underneath here or something more than that. And by the way, that's just the browser, right? Browser doing its thing. So if I look at this, the only JS, I didn't need JS functions, but I did, and I recommend doing this wherever you can. Get name. Like this is all I had to do for that was just to query selector by that ID name, add a submit listener. And this is actually where I will also write that validation code, prevent default, get the name. And in this case, I had to do target.elements, first element of the value, because I was doing it off of a form. Okay. And then I just set that to blank so that if we come back later, it won't be there. And then I do location.assign to the todo.html. So what used to be the index file for the todo is now an actual todo. Not an actual, but a todo.html by passing in that name, which is what we saw before. Now, the approaches I was taking before were just, I was trying to dynamically output this once you gave me the name, doing some showing and hiding of just a div in here. And the I've done that before, and honestly, this is the reason frameworks like React, Vue, Angular, and others exist, is because doing this with straight HTML can become kind of a pain sometimes. But again, I'm just showing you the way I've done it. So now what I had to modify about the to-dos was I, and by the way, if you come in, if you try to come into this page without a name, it'll send you right back. And that's basically this, just this easy little if statement, and the getting the hash is pulling off that name. And then I just wrote a function called display header text. I'll show you that in a minute. And then I added, actually, let me just go ahead and show you that now. It's in my to-do functions. I put it right at the bottom. All I had to do here was just dynamically create that when somebody does enter a name, right? So it dynamically creates that and then sets up the button. And then when the button is changed, it just redirects them to the index.html, okay, without, of course, anything to pull off the hash, which tells it, you know. And actually, I could do the reverse too on the other one, is if it is being sent back to the index, but there's a hash on it automatically. So I could handle that both ways. So again, this is doesn't seem like a big deal, but you should have seen the ways I was doing it before. Matter of fact, I think I have a backup here, because when I was trying it this way, it was like just way too complicated. So the other thing I did is and I'll show you this on the to-do apps, is I added to the where it actually is pushing that object into that array, and I added name on there. Okay, so I had to capture so that way when you look in local storage, come down here and I can show you this. My mouse is not happy. Not a happy mouse. Okay, so down here, you can see, right, if you look at these to-dos, I have captured the name. So I've done that. The other way that I, and this, again, like the light popped on when I was walking home today, when I realized the easy way to do this, besides just what I've shown you, is just to modify my rendered to-dos, because that's every time you render a to-do, and I'll show you this in the functions, because that's really, again, it's like when you know, hindsight's 20/20. So in here, what I did is I just added, when you do the filtered to-dos, when you're setting up all these, right, is it true, then all I did was add a search by name match and say if the to-do.name is includes name. Now, in this case, name is a global variable that has been set here, right here, okay? So I could pass it in, but I'm just telling you it is a global variable for that reason, because you'd want to have it. I could absolutely, the other way I thought, I could actually just add the filters and place it in there. That's another way to do it. And then in this case, I just returned if this and this and this was true, the individual to do. Okay. And from there on, I was thinking there might be a few other places I'd have to do some things, but I didn't. And that's the really great thing about when you're modifying a well-written program, you really learn at so many different levels, right, about how easy it is to maintain and add features to it. But the key is to give yourself enough time. And the reason I think this is a good assignment is that, you know, because this stuff, depending on who you are, depending on your level of understanding, can take time. I mean, it takes me time. I just have to give myself that space to be able to allow that understanding to kind of seep in between what I'm trying to create and what the code is already set up to do, and how I can most simply modify it for my needs. So anyway, have fun with this. Give me your link. Reply to two students, and I've already talked about the reserve here. But at this point, and you know, it's always good to talk about where we're at, but I believe we're about 2 weeks away, week 10, 11, 12. Yep, that would be true. Let me just drop that off, right? So right before we head out, so at this week, it'll be this week. Yep, we'll be 2 weeks away. So at this point, honestly, given our assignments here, this would be a perfect time for you to start working on your Dev 1. And honestly, it was last week, but I'm just trying to kind of encourage you through the assignments and to help you see other ways to do things. All right, have a great week. Talk to you later.